Leader Brief. Where does generative AI fit in the AI landscape? Artificial intelligence, or AI, is a field of computer science where we try to mimic human-like cognitive abilities in computers. To do that, we need to somehow represent the real world inside the computer's memory, so that representation can be used to understand and make inferences about the real world. For example, say you represent the following in a computer: a map of your town that includes the roads, your house on the map, and a restaurant where your friends are meeting. You also represent transportation modes like walking, cycling, and driving, and you know the average speed of these modes. The computer can then compute how long it takes to go to the restaurant based on your mode. This is useful information because you can time when to leave the house. Essentially, you have modeled the real world in the computer and used that model to give you some useful information so that you can plan things in the real world. The first step to AI is to represent knowledge about the real world. There are two significant ways to represent this knowledge in the computer's memory. One is a symbolic way, where things are represented as symbols. You can then manipulate the symbols to make inferences about the world. As symbols, your home may be the starting point, the restaurant the destination, and the road links with lengths and connections with other roads. You can then program the computer to find the time to travel between your home and the restaurant. This is a human understandable representation of the real world. The other way to represent knowledge is plain data, such as the pixels in the picture of a map. As data, your home is a group of a few pixels, and so is the restaurant, and the roads, etc. In this case, the computer has represented this map in a complex model called a neural network. Now, to find the travel time between your home and the restaurant, you feed the two points on the map and the mode of transportation. The computer will give you the travel distance and time. With images as input, you don't exactly know how the computer represented the knowledge in a neural network. This is still a field of research. Earlier, researchers thought that the symbolic way of knowledge representation was the best way to achieve artificial intelligence. It seems so natural that even dogs seem to model symbols, as we can see Zeus do.
Six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
But surprisingly, with more computing power available, we found out that deep learning models can represent complex world concepts with basic pixel data and somehow come to correct conclusions most of the time, if trained correctly. This formed the basis of deep learning research. So where does generative AI, such as ChatGPT, fit into all this? We already know that AI has two ways to represent the real world, using symbols and using data. The data representation is through a process called machine learning. Here, different models represent the data. Some models are simple, like equations or decision trees, and others are more complex. One particular set of models to represent complex knowledge are called deep neural networks because they have many layers. The way we train these networks is called deep learning. So deep learning is a subset of machine learning. One variation of deep neural networks is called a convolution neural network. This type can represent images captured on a camera, just like how humans use eyes to see and analyze the world around them. Another variation of the deep neural network is called a recurrent neural network. This type can represent temporal patterns such as voice, and we can use it for voice to text conversion. Yet another variation of the deep neural network is called a transformer. This type can represent relationships between words in a language, such as the words in a book or even the internet. We use this type of network to build large language models. Transformer models learn content from a large corpus of words, such as from the internet, that includes billions of pages of text. It then organizes these words internally. These models based on the transformer neural network are called foundational models. We can then further train these foundational models for specific tasks, like a chat-based question and answer model. That's essentially ChatGPT. You may decide to train it for other things, like generating code or making medical diagnoses, which are specialized versions of the foundational models. That's how generative AI fits into the AI landscape. If you enjoyed watching this video, please consider subscribing. Please sign up on my website for a one-page visual summary of this video. Thank you.